Welcome to a breakdown of the 46-2 solo. In this video, I'm going to break down literally measure by measure of the sheets right here. We're going to be going at slower speed here to go through each individual note. The full playthrough, I did not play note for note. The solo is pretty difficult, but in this run through, I will be going note for note. So let's take the first measure, which is going to be essentially six tuplets. Five groups of six tuplets, starting on the snare, going to tom one, tom two, tom three, tom four, and then a ending, which I will play here in a moment. So it sounds like this, slow. So it's basically gonna be, again, six tuplets starting on the snare, going down. And then the last part is going to be the last tom is the downbeat. Then he usually goes up in the various videos to the other floor tom. So these next two measures is going to be easiest to lump everything together as opposed to separating the two. So I'm going to play it real quick and then I'll explain some things. So for counting, I think it's best to go one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, and that's when you hit the ride crash. So as you can see in the sheets, RC is going to be ride crash. So that's just hitting the edge of the ride. And then everything else, you can pretty much play on one crash cymbal. So we are now on bar four. This is pretty straightforward. It is notated as 8-4, so you can think of it as two bars of 4-4. Again, it starts with the crash and bass drum, two bass drum hits, similar to measure two. So we are on measure four. Here's what that sounds like. Okay, so that is gonna be a lead-in to the next of the double bass part. But that is essentially two measures of 4-4. We're on bar five, and this is gonna be 16th notes throughout the entire thing. We're back in 7-4 time. So starts out with a crash on the snare and the bass drum, essentially. And then every other hit is gonna be the edge of the ride cymbal. Okay, and this is just, I mean, you can play it wherever you want, but this is what I heard on the track when I transcribed it. So it's gonna sound like this. And notice how the last beat, and you'll see on the sheets here, does not have a snare, okay? And that's just what he plays on the track. We are on bar six. Again, bass drum and crash, two bass drum hits, and there is one edge ride crash in here as well. So here's what that sounds like. Okay. Bar seven is going to be one crash, and then we're only, the only groupings is gonna be one crash, and then he plays everything on one tom, and I chose tom two, which is right here, okay? So that is gonna sound like this. Okay, now notice on the last tom hit, there's no ride cymbal, okay? So everything's together, except for that last one, which again, if you're a stickler for the details, don't play ride cymbal on the last hit. We are on bar eight, okay? Pretty straightforward, mental note, one edge crash on the ride there. Here's what that sounds like. Okay, this is literally the first time any, or the second time a floor tom is gonna be played, okay? And the orchestration of the toms, if you wanna switch them or something like that, you can. That's just the way that I notated it. Okay, on to bar nine. We're gonna be looking at mental note, two ride edge crashes, okay? And this is just, there's no toms, okay? Little double bass action in this. Here's what that sounds like. Okay. Pretty straightforward. Bar 10, again, starts the exact same way, except this starts with a China hit, okay? So gonna start with a China, similar pattern to bar 9. Here's what that sounds like. And notice how sometimes I'm hitting on the edge of the ride, sometimes I'm hitting the top of the ride cymbal, okay? Or the bow in the edge, if you will, all right? And that just adds a little bit more color, okay? Now this is the tricky part, okay? Bars 11 and 12 have the same pattern repeated throughout, okay? And that pattern very slowly is going to sound like this, okay? And you can watch Danny Carey's videos. He kind of changes this up slightly. He actually changes the solo up slightly as well, but this part largely stays the same, okay? It's gonna be snare, tom two, okay? Notice I have a smaller tom here, so tom two. Snare, tom two, two kick drums, okay? Okay? Then you're gonna go to your floor tom and tom three. So it's tom three and tom four. And you're gonna play four notes, right, left, and then two kicks. Okay? And if you notice on the notation, it's 30 seconds and then six tuplets. Okay? So it's gonna sound like this very slow. Okay? That's literally the whole pattern, except he plays it a lot faster than that. So at the tempo we were going before, about right there, think of the accents on the dotted quarter. Da, 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 da. Da, 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 da. That's the pattern, okay? So two bars of seven. Here's what it sounds like slower than on the track. The last pattern is going to be snare tom two, kick, kick, floor tom, tom two, kick, kick. And then a snare drum. So again, bars 11 and 12 together. So what makes this difficult is it's kind of like an inverted flam. Instead of playing a flam which is left-right, you're actually playing right-left. So, but it's kind of a, it's like an inverted flam. So you're accenting the first, it's interesting. I'm not sure if it's an inverted flam or not. I'm not sure if that's technically the right way of saying it, but it is, instead of playing this, you're actually playing. So you're gonna have to do it at your own risk, but in order to hit that accented pattern, then you'll need to put the second note on the tom. So here we go, we're gonna play the solo at the slower tempo and try to make sure we keep all those little intricacies in mind. So there you go. That's the solo broken down. You have the playthrough up to speed and you have the playthrough at the slower speed. What I really found the most challenging was that last pattern and really getting the feel and the orchestration on the toms. But use each measure as like a reset because it all, like most of the measures start with a crash on beat one and two bass drum hits. So there's at least a bit of form and a bit of consistency there. feel free to leave a comment below and hit me up on Instagram, Hefe Plays Drums, if you have any questions. If you do try the solo, post the video, tag me. Love to see it. Peace and love. Happy drumming.